Hello students, myself Ramya. I am going to solve the problems from exercise 1.1. So I hope those who missed your classes or getting confused to solve can refer my videos and get clarified from this. Let's solve the problem from exercise 1.1. The first sum is find the adjoint of the matrices. So this is the given matrix. So let's take the given matrix as A matrix. So the given matrix is in the form of 2 by 2 matrix, which means row and column is 2. There are 2 rows and 2 columns. So to find the adjoint of the matrix for 2 by 2 matrix is very easy. Just we have to relocate the place of an element. We have to relocate, in the sense the minus 4 will go there for this cross section. The minus 4 will go there and 3 will come here for this cross section. And for this cross section, we don't want to relocate the place. By the same time, we have to alternate the sign. Here, minus 1 is present. So, we have to make it into as plus. Here, plus 2 is there. So, we have to put it into as minus. So, likewise, we have to alternate the sign. For this cross section, we have to relocate the place. So, adjoint of A for 2 by 2 matrix is minus 4 will go there and 3 will come here. And minus 1 will be considered as plus 1 and plus 2 will be considered as minus 2. So this is the answer for first sum. So and then the second problem is find the adjoint of the matrix A is equal to 1, 2, 3, minus 5 and verify A into adjoint of A is equal to adjoint of A into A is equal to modulus of A into I. So we have to prove A into adjoint of A, which is equal to adjoint of A into A, which is equal to modulus of A into I. So first we'll find out modulus of A into I. Modulus of A can be determined from A matrix, and I is nothing but identity matrix. The given matrix is in the form of 2 by 2 matrix, because A is in the form of 2 by 2 matrix. For 2 by 2 matrix, identity matrix is 1 0 0 1. Okay, I matrix is 1 0 0 1. This is for 2 by 2 matrix. And next we have to find modulus of A. Modulus of A can be determined from A matrix. How to find modulus of A from A matrix? Just we have to cross multiply. 1 into minus 5 will give minus 5, minus of 3 into 2 gives 6. So minus 5 minus 6 both are having same sign. So we have to add and put the same sign. So modulus of A is nothing but minus 11. After that we have to multiply modulus of A with I. So what we have found modulus of A? Minus 11, which will be multiplied with I matrix. I matrix for 2 by 2 is 1 0 0 1. We have to multiply minus 11 inside the matrix. For each element we have to multiply minus 11 into 1, which gives minus 11. Minus 11 into 0 gives 0, and minus 11 into 0 gives 0. Minus 11 into 1 gives minus 11. So we have found modulus of A into I is equal to minus 11 0 0 minus 11. After that, after finding modulus of A into I, the next we have to go for A into adjoint of A and adjoint of A into A. So before going to prove A into adjoint of A, we have to know what is adjoint of A. As I have told before, how to find adjoint of A for 2 by 2 matrix, it's nothing but we have to just from A matrix 1, 2, 3, minus 5, just we have to relocate the place of an element for this cross section. So minus 5 will go there and plus 1 will come here. And for this cross section, we have to alternate the sign. So if there is plus present, we have to put it into as minus. And if there is minus present, we have to make it into as plus. Likewise, we have to do for this cross section, but we don't want to relocate the place of an element for this cross section. So adjoint of A for this matrix is this minus 5 will go there, so minus 5, and 1 will come here, so 1, and both are having plus sign. So plus sign mean we have to make it into as minus, so minus 2, here plus is present, so we have to put it into as minus 3. So adjoint of A is minus 5 minus 2 minus 3 1. This is adjoint of A. So after finding adjoint of A, we can find out what is A into adjoint of A. A is nothing but given matrix, which is multiplied with adjoint of matrix. So this row is multiplied with this column and this column. So first column and second column. So the first row is 1, 2. The first row of and first element 1, which is multiplied with first column of first element. So 1 into minus 5 will give minus 5. Then second element of first row is multiplied with second element of first column. So 2 into minus 3, so minus 6, plus into minus, minus 2, 3, 2 into 3, 6. So minus 5, minus 6. After that, this first element of first row is multiplied with first element of second column. So 1 into minus 2 will give minus 2. Then 2 second element of first row is multiplied with second element of second column. So 2 into 1 gives plus 2. Likewise, the second row, in second row, the first element is multiplied with first element of first column. So 3 into minus 5 will give 3 into minus 5, 15. 3 into 5, 15. Plus into minus, minus. Then second element of second row is multiplied with second element of first column. So 5 into 3 gives 15. Here minus into minus, minus 5 and minus 3. So minus into minus, which gives plus 5 into 3, 15. After that, the second row, in second row, the first element, which is 3, 3 is multiplied with first element of second column. In second column, minus 2. Okay, so 3 into 2, 3 into minus 2, 3 into 2, 6, plus into minus, minus. After that, the second element of second row is multiplied with second element of second column. So 5 into 1, after multiplying, which gives 5, plus into minus, which gives minus. So after that, we have to simplify. A into adjoint of A is nothing but both are having the same sign, so we have to add and put the same sign. So here minus 2 and plus 2 will get cancelled with each other. Here minus 15 and plus 15 will get cancelled with each other. Here both are having same sign, we have to add and put the same sign. So A into adjoint of A is equal to minus 11, 0, 0, minus 11. Next we have to find what is adjoint of A into A. Adjoint of A we have found already, and A is nothing but given matrix, both are multiplying with each other. How to find? The first row is multiplied with the first column, and first row is multiplied with the second column. Likewise, the second row is multiplied with first column, and the second row is multiplied with second column. So let's go into the detail. Minus 5, the first element of one first row is multiplied with first element of one first column. So minus 5 into 1, which gives minus 5. Then next, the second element of one first row is multiplied with second element of one first column. So minus 2 into 3 gives 2, 3, which gives 6. After multiplying, 2 into 3, 6. Plus and minus, which gives minus. The next thing is, the first element of one first row is multiplied with first element of one second column. So here second column is 2 minus 5. So first element of one first row is multiplied with first element of one second column. So 5 into 2 gives 10, minus 5 plus 2. So plus into minus, minus. So minus 10 here. Then we have to multiply this second element of one first row, which is multiplied with second element of one second column. So 2 into 5, which gives 10. Here also minus, here also minus. While we are multiplying minus into minus, which gives plus. So plus 10. After that, we have to multiply this row into this column. So the first element of one second row is minus 3, which is multiplied with first column in first element. So minus 3 into 1, which gives minus 3. Next, the second element of one second row is 1, which is multiplied with second element of one first column. So 1 into 3 gives 3. After that, the first element of one first second row is which is minus 3, multiplied with first element of one second column. So 3 into 2 gives 6. Plus into minus, which gives minus. Likewise, the second element of one second row is 1, which is multiplied with the second element of one second column. So 1 into minus 5, which gives minus 5. After that, we have to simplify the steps. Both are having the same sign, so we have to add and put the same sign. Here plus and minus will get cancelled with each other, so plus minus plus 10 and minus 10 will get cancelled with each other. Here minus 3 and plus 3 will get cancelled with each other, so it will be 0 0. Here both are having the same sign, we have to add and put the same sign. So what we have found here is adjoint of A into A is minus 11 0 0 minus 11. After finding A into adjoint of A, adjoint of A into A and modulus of A into I, we can conclude that all are equal and same, which is equal to minus 11, 0, 0, minus 11. So hence it is proved.